Hi, my name is Natalie, and I'm the founder of The Unchargeables Chronic Illness Support Group. And in this video, I want to explain to you what a fibro flare is and what it feels like. Now, I have been in a flare for over a week, and I'm going to tell you more about that in a moment. But first, I'm going to explain to you what is a flare. So whichever chronic illness you have, it can be fibromyalgia, Hashimoto arthritis, I don't know, MS, lupus, there's a whole bunch. A flare basically means that all of your symptoms are increased and that you feel bad, basically. So all of your symptoms are more extreme than they normally are all at the same time, and we refer to that as a flare. So I want to explain to you what I feel when I have a fibro flare, so a fibromyalgia flare up of my symptoms. Now, I have to be honest, I have no clue if this flare is due to my fibromyalgia, due to my Hashimoto's, due to all of my other autoimmune diseases, or to some sort of unknown cause. It can also be changes in the weather, or that I've just done too much. I know that I've done too much, but my flare seems to be worsening and I don't know why. So what do I experience when I have a flare? Well, first of all, right now my hip is really inflamed and it's hurting, and it's been like that for a week, and the pain is kind of traveling from my hip into my lower back and up in the back of my shoulder blades right now. It feels like my hip is on fire, and then there's also a nerve stuck. So that one just feels like a stabbing pain. I'm really extremely tired, which could be the pain, which could be a flare, which could be the fact that I'm in a hotel room and not in my house. But at home, I am this tired as well when I get a flare. So it's not very, very visible right now because it's afternoon and I'm doing okay. But when I wake up, like, my eyes will be very, very puffy. And maybe I'll have like blue bags under my eyes. It's not all too bad right now, but it's a little bit puffy. And this will get really puffy. And this will also get really puffy. What I'm also experiencing right now is a ringing in my ears. I've been having that for like 4 days. It's super annoying. I have no clue what I can do about it, and I just kind of ignore it. But I know it's not normal. So non-stop ringing in my ears. My throat, I don't have a throat ache and I don't have a throat infection, but it just feels raw and annoying and warm and swollen. I think it's also like my lymph nodes are swollen, so my lymph nodes will swell up when I'm in a flare. The other thing that I have, yes, there's more, the list goes on. The other thing that I have is like this sort of tension headache, but it's not really a headache because my head doesn't hurt. It's like a pressure in my head. And that could be due to the weather, because where I am right now, it's raining, it's very humid, and it's cold, and that really affects me with the, like, the puffiness of my eyes. My fingers will bloat. And this irritation in my head is like a pressure, which feels like there's a headache coming, but I've had this now for 4 days as well. I don't really know what to do about that. So basically, those are my symptoms when I'm in a flare. I could have constipation. I could have diarrhea. I could have anything going wrong with my GI tract. It kind of varies from time to time. So now my hip is inflamed. That doesn't happen very often for me. For me, it's usually either in between my shoulder blades or here in my neck on the right side. And now it's my left hip. It could be nausea. I'm not nauseous right now, and most of the time I am nauseous. What do I do when I'm in a flare? I kind of just lay down and try to work through it, kind of like when you have the flu and you have to just wait until you feel better. That's kind of the way it works with me, like when I'm in a flare, but a flare can take days, weeks, and sometimes even months. And like, I don't want to stay in bed for months. So, what I will do is just rest a lot, try to get up and move around a couple times per day. I will make sure that I take a lot of my supplements, especially magnesium. When I'm in a flare where my neck hurts or where my hip is inflamed, the magnesium will help lower the inflammation. I will take some other supplements. My essential oils help me, and I have some homeopathic anti-inflammatories. I don't personally use any pharmaceuticals. And that's basically, yeah, what it feels like when I'm in a flare and what I do about it. Like I said, there's not really a lot that I can do but wait for it to pass, because it always passes. But I try to help my body. I don't have an appetite, so for me it's very hard to keep eating, but I make sure that I eat twice, three times per day, because I notice that when I don't eat, I feel worse. And try to stay positive. I think that is the hardest one. It's really the hardest one, to try and stay positive when you feel like that. And for me, it's now been a week and I'm stuck abroad. I'm not at home. I'm in a hotel. So I've been traveling. I overdid it. And my body just basically told me, yeah, that was it, a day before I was supposed to go home. So it's hard to stay positive by myself in a hotel room, but I do try and focus on all the good things and that I really enjoyed this trip. And my body just need rest to recover, and hopefully I can go home soon. So, whichever flare you are in or have been in, just try to relax your body, support it with natural supplements and essential oils. Make sure you keep eating and stay positive. You will get out of it after a while. Thank you so much for listening to another one of my stories. If you want to hear more of my stories, go and check out the YouTube channel and our Facebook page, where all of the videos are listed, so you can see all of the stories. I release a new story every Thursday. And if you like it, give it a thumbs up and follow us, subscribe, and I'll see you in the next video.